joined by Trow Fear. We are looking forward to a great best of three ahead of us here on what is Complexity Gaming versus Doo-Wop here in a loser's bracket matchup. You lose, you are done. Really excited to see what happens here. This being a four-team tournament, one of these four teams going to the main event, of course, for the Summit Six. So I'm excited to be here. Hopefully you guys are. Somebody else hopefully excited to be here, the one, the only, Trow. How's it going, Trow?
It's going very well, man. It was fun casting with you yesterday. We had It was actually a one-sided match, to be honest.
Oh, my
and
gosh.
Those of you who didn't catch it should, because even though it was one-sided, it was actually pretty fun to watch. But, I mean, Complexity just got absolutely stomped. And I think this series is going to be a big test for them and will kind of show the community what they're made of in terms of, like, their new roster, their new role assignments, and whether the last match was just a fluke or not. So we'll see.
Exactly. All the pressure has to be on Complexity, right? I mean, this is their first big event, you know, post the whole roster change and everything. And now, see, it's one thing yesterday against MP, as you stated. They got stomped, whatever. It's a day, it happens. This is a new day, and you're going up against a team in Doo-Wop here. Now, I'm not going to sit here and say that this is a bad team by any means, but this is a team that had to grind through some qualifiers to get to this point. On paper, you would think an organization, like, Complexity should be the favorites here, right? Or, I mean, what do you think about Doo-Wop?
I think they're, well, again, it's hard to say. Like, it's hard to call a team that's brand new with a new roster debuting a favorite in any, even if it's like, you know, the new Team Secret or the new EG.
Drop real quickly. Yeah. I hear you're in-game mic, too.
Okay, you have to do the mute broadcasters thing. I heard yours, too. It's under the audio. It's like the third option.
Mute co-broadcast. Okay, there we go. Gotcha. All right. All this fancy technology, man. All right.
I forgot to do it, too, but luckily, luckily I had a space there to do it. But
we're good. Okay. Anyways, about Doo-Wop here, yeah.
Yeah, no, it's hard to call any team a favorite that's debuting a new roster, with especially new role assignments. That being said, yes, we did see them yesterday, so it's a little bit easier to make a prediction, I guess. But, I mean, NP, I think, is just grinded out through some games, has got a little bit more experience under their belt, and they looked a lot better than when I first saw them personally. So I think that they're, in terms of them versus Doo-Wop, they're much better. So I don't know. It's hard to say again who's the favorite. I don't know, man.
Let's just wait
and see. Based off what we saw yesterday alone, I would have to say Doo-Wop, just because Complexity just looked lost. I'm sorry, but they did not look very strong. But again, we'll see if it was a fluke.
Yeah, we'll see. And obviously the draft is underway, so let's start taking a look at that. We have the Drow OD bands coming out from Doo-Wop over here, Batrider Shadow Demon bands from Complexity. We have the Oracle, and I think it went Wisp, Ursa, and then Timbersaw, if I'm not mistaken. But pick so far? Any insight there, Trow?
Well, we know that Complexity, even with their new roster, they like the Wisp overall. I think they picked it first overall yesterday, too. Whether it was first overall or first two, I can't remember.
Yeah.
It didn't work out for them, but I know that Z-Freak plays a very, very good Wisp. Didn't have the best opportunities to save people last game just because it was so one-sided, but does play. You know what? They picked the same exact duo yesterday, I believe.
They did,
Io
yes.
and Ursa. So they're going with more of the same. They're like, hey, that was just a fluke yesterday. We're ready. Again, picking Ursa into Timbersaw is actually pretty good, especially if you can find a lane where they're matched up against each other, because the reactive armor just doesn't really do anything against the Fury Swipes of Ursa. So that's kind of the reasoning for picking the Ursa against the Timber. Then the question becomes, are you going to be able to find where the Timbersaw is laning? If you're not going to be able to, is it really that big of a deal to pick Ursa? You can still burst him down with a blink. I mean, it's still a great hero against him, so we'll see. Oracle is just good against anybody, though, like specifically the Ursa. Melee cores that kind of run at you like a Sven. So relatively even draft, I'd say, here.
All right, some extra time being used here, the reserve time even. We got Death Prophet ban and then Phantom Assassin ban. We got to see that support Phantom Assassin. I wonder if that's a little bit of a we just don't want to have to deal with that again. You know, maybe not, but
whether it's support or not, the Stifling Dagger is the same, and the slow effect happening every 5 seconds or 6 seconds cooldown, I think it is just a way to kite the Ursa very, very easily. So support or not, it's a hard thing to deal with.
Yeah. All right, so 50 seconds now for Doo-Wop again. This is a loser's bracket matchup, so like we're talking about, obviously you have to win to stay alive here. And the other side of it, I believe happening at the same time right now, Team NP versus FDL. They're taking place in the winner bracket finals, of course, A lot of people interested in that one there, so keep an eye on that. And I believe the main Beyond the Summit channel, they are casting that as well. So, but we got this series, and again, Complexity, a big focus here as far as the new roster and everything. But expecting to see that with Cancel again, if it's the same as yesterday, the Ursa Cancel, Cancel playing Ursa, that is. That's what we happened yesterday, so.
And he did solo kill Envy in, like, the first 2 minutes. Keep that in mind. So the first game, there was a kind of a weird situation. I'm just recapping for those of you that hadn't seen, where he lost his courier in mid, just it mismicroed it, and Envy actually pulled ahead in mid. With that not happening, though, he had Ursa versus Envy's Invoker, and he dominated him early on. Yeah. I mean, he solo killed him. Whether it was Envy playing way too far up or what have you, he capitalized on the situation and dominated that lane. So we'll see if we can see more of the same here from Cancel.
There's Storm Spirit after all that time. They spent a lot of reserve time thinking about that Storm Spirit ban right there, and they finally go with it. There's a Kunkka taken out now, and a quick pick on the Sand King in response from Doowop here. But taking out the Storm Spirit. I mean, again, we saw the mid Ursa, again, going with that recap that you're just going off of, but they still take out the Storm Spirit. You think that was a smart ban by them?
Maybe they just have plans in their draft where they're not going to have too much catch, although they did just pick up Sand King, so that's interesting. You know, Storm Spirit, it's good against Oracle and Timber because they don't have ways of locking you down. And you can kind of kite out the ult from Oracle and wait and then kind of re-engage once it's done. Timbersaw, the only way you can really deal with a Storm is maybe a Yule Scepter, but even then that's not really a counter. It's just kind of a way to stop him from moving around a ton. So maybe they just wanted to draft something that didn't have a ton of counters to him and didn't want to have to deal with it. Storm IO is very strong because it gives him kind of an unlimited mana pool.
Leshrac coming out. Now, I've heard stories about this hero. Yeah, he's had times in the Dota history where he's been very powerful. I don't think now is that time, though. So
I agree. I think it has to be a core. I don't think you can run IO Ursa with a Leshrac as four unless you have two other cores that really have good setup stuns. I mean, a Wisp has absolutely nothing. Maybe you can slow with a Tether Break and slow him that way. But the stun, the Split Earth, is just god-awful at level one. So I would expect it to be some kind of core position. I know that Melange likes to run the Leshrac in core. We haven't seen it for quite some time. So expect to see that in core, and then, I'd be very surprised to see that as a roaming four position, especially considering the fact that I'm pretty sure Z-Freak is playing the Wisp, and I don't think that Melange will play the Leshrac if it's a support.
Okay. Faceless Void coming out. A fourth pick. You could be. But we'll reserve judgment here until it actually happens. That's the other thing, too. I know a lot of people are going to be focused on, of course, the big talk, as well as his new rosters. Melon's playing that support role once again, and now who he ends up playing here, we'll have to wait and see. But Leshrac or another support is what we're getting at. Well, they're figuring out that fourth pick right now, using plenty of reserve time to do so. So if you think that's going to be a core, still need their offlane as well as that four position, then it feels like. So, what is Slaughter still on the board? Yeah, Slaughter's still on the board. Would that be an option here, you think?
Slaughter's good. Yeah, Slardar is always a good hero to have. It's just there's not really a counter to Slardar. It'd be a good setup for the relocates. You know, something we saw yesterday with it was NP, right, where they had the Nyx roaming around in Invis looking for relocate ganks.
Yes.
You know, initiated on them, and then the relocate happened, and it was easy peasy.
Yeah.
Maybe they could do something like that with they could pick up Nyx themselves. It's very good against Timbersaw. It's very good in general, honestly. So expect that to be coming out from Complexity. Slardar, like you said, is not bad. Things like that. Void actually would have been good, too. Although the Chronosphere combined with Ursa doesn't really synergize well. And there's the Nyx Assassin.
Yeah, a little bit of a taste of things to come from yesterday's mention. Of course, NP running that against him, and it did do very well with that IO combination. So going to give it a chance themselves here with the Nyx pickup. And now the final bans to come. So, if you do up here, it's like, okay, they are going to ban a Naga, so they don't, well, I guess that could be
It's a common counter nowadays to the Void ult. So when he comes in Chronospheres, whether it's a Naga, typically a Naga support, and then Naga will sit back, wait, and use the Song of the Siren to kind of disengage during that ulti. So they don't want any of that happening.
You know, something else I was actually looking into it a little bit as Templar Assassin Man coming out, but we're looking at Ziz over here for Doowop, by the way, who is obviously a former Complexity member.
That's right.
Teammates of Melons and Z-Freak. So you know that there's always that wanting to defeat your former teammates mentality there, I'm sure. But
that's a really good point to bring up. I didn't even think of that. Well, he was a new addition to this roster. It used to be Mason playing for Duop, and then he up and left after some disappointing results. So anyway, Tinker picked up here for Complexity, so it is going to be a support Leshrac, believe it or not.
All right.
Unless they did like a support Nyx and went aggro tri-lane, but that, yeah, no, it's going to be Mew on the Nyx.
Remember how you said you could be wrong?
I was wrong.
You were wrong.
I was left. And then, yeah, Klink's picked up. These last two picks were so fast, so it's hard to really analyze this. But it's going to be Wei 2 on the Sand King, so support duo with Sand King Oracle. I think that's totally fine. It gives you a nice balance of ranged nukes and, you know, like a good melee stun. I think Duop has a very well-rounded lineup, and it's going to be interesting to see Complexity's lineup because they picked a lot of heroes we don't see that often. We don't see Ursa a whole lot. We never see Leshrac. And Tinker's, you know, kind of fallen out of favor.
The Leshrac support. That's going to be fun to see again in the hands of Melons.
And it's a five. This is like not a, like, he's bought the Ward's Courier. He's TPing to the lane. He has nothing in stats. So he's going to have to rely on some really, you know, skill shot stuns landing here with no setups or very little setups. So I guess the best setup in lane is like an Ursa Stomp, but again, it's still very, very hard to hit.
Do you think their mentality changed in the draft? Like, because, I mean, it's just this Leshrac really does feel kind of out of place. I mean, what are the benefits of Leshrac? If you have the setup stun, I guess it could be powerful. You can bring some push presence, right? So,
yeah.
They're not really that, though, necessarily, so.
Well, if they went push, we will expect to see a Split Earth and Diabolic Edict build. Maybe they're thinking, okay, Ursa has a hard time pushing. Maybe they knew from the get-go they wanted the last pick Tinker. And they're like, okay, Tinker has terrible pushing, so we need someone to kind of reach high ground and hit these towers.
Yeah.
I don't know, but I just don't think that reasoning warrants a 5-support Leshrac with a Wisp. We'll have to see. Time will only tell. I will say that the last pick Klinx is very, very strong against someone like Leshrac. You get any semblance of farm on on the Klinx, and he's going to be able to, like, 3-shot that Leshrac with 0 items, so watch out for that.
Yeah. The battle begins. Klinks definitely seems like it can be fun to observe here throughout this game. In the hands of Ziz, of course, going back to, again, former teammate of Melons and Z-Freak over there, so for to see how he plays. But, yeah, as far as the roster for Duop, folks, a lot of complexity here. We got Wei 2 playing the Sand King, Ziz on that Klinks, Flea on the Faceless Void, Snake King, of course, on Timbersaw, and that leaves Jason on Oracle here. Or their side. So Moose headed to the top with that Nyx. Probably going to have a tough time, you'd assume. Double Mango here.
Yeah, Nyx has extremely high base regen. One of the highest, I think, in the game, if not the highest. And so you supplement that with, like, the Mangoes to give yourself even more regen and the Stout Shield. And if you manage to get any little bit of farm to get a PMS, then it's just going to be really hard to harass him out of lane. Although Jason's doing a pretty decent job right now.
Yeah. Kind of standing toe-to-toe with him, going to force him at half-life currently, so we'll have to fall back and let that natural regen kind of kick in for the time being. But middle lane ends up being the Tinker and the Wisp taking on the Timbersaw here. Obviously, with the support, you'd figure Tinker should have a pretty good time, but makes sense to you as far as putting the Wisp there and having him babysit?
I'm not sold. I think as long as Wisp is stacking, but he missed the first wave of stacks on the first minute, so he didn't stack this hard camp down here, he didn't stack the medium camp right there, and this is a double archer coming in the way of snaking, so if he doesn't die right here right now to cancel in the next 30 seconds, he'll be fine. Oh, he gets his self canceled, so that's really bad for him. Cancel can play really, really aggressive now, and he needs to, because this is a huge wave, and he doesn't want snaking to take advantage of any of that, so watch and see how aggressive he plays here. Lasers him once, not gonna be able to last hit for a little bit. That's a creep he's going to be able to deny. Oh, Snake King actually missed that. So look at how low he is. And he's going to have to ferry maybe another health potion. Misses that. Oh, he gets that one. So actually, Snake King did not too bad right there.
Played it pretty well, it sounds like. So, yeah, 8-5 Tinker, though, compared to that 4-0 Timbersaw currently. So again, understandably, can't stop in the better time. Continues the pressure. Seeing Wisp rotate up here to the top lane. The ping's coming out up here.
One auto attack and Snake King's dead.
Oh my god, he got it. The laser.
I like how he whirling deathed right before the rocket hit, as if that, like, did something.
It's like a panic mode, like, do something!
Yeah. Like, oh, maybe it'll heal me somehow, that whirling death!
I forget how this hero works for a fraction of a second. Yeah, that's the panic might as well try something kind of deal. But yeah, first blood, that's a big start, obviously. Cancel looking good there.
He played it well. He knew that when this huge wave was coming in the way of snaking, he couldn't just sit back and let it happen. He had to be aggressive. He had to kind of screw with the mind of snaking, try to just be aggressive as possible, and it worked out. So yeah. Very well played from Cancel.
Other lanes, I mean, again, constantly Wisp sitting up here and pinging. I mean, I don't think, can the Nyx Wisp actually get a kill this early on?
Nyx Wisp.
Yeah.
No. It's almost impossible to get a kill on Snake, or Snake King, Sand King.
So that's what I'm kind of wondering. Why is Wisp up here then, you think? Why is he trying to support up there?
Not sure. I'm really not sure. Yeah. I really feel like his time should be spent stacking. He did help mid just a little bit, but I'm not exactly sure what his role is right now in the first 3 minutes. We'll have to wait and see. Maybe he's just waiting to heal somebody and sitting behind lanes that he thinks are going to get harassed, but mid's just fine. Top is, I don't think Mu's really going to die. Mu hasn't even leveled up a skill. He's waiting to,
there he goes.
I think it's one.
Gets that
impale. And he gets a second.
Right as you mentioned it, there's the impale effect to use on Aziz, taking some harassment. Aziz, though, the early Ring of Bacillus here, and looking strong with his start, of course, as far as the last hitting goes. But Urza slightly ahead, so obviously the other lane's not much contestion going on there. As though he's going to be immobilized at the top here, but impale, and he'll just walk away. So continues to be fine. I've seen Melons, though, stacking in the jungle quite a bit, doing some of these pulls here, so it seems like he's been fairly effective. I mean, he's level 4 as a support, so doing solid, it feels like.
Yeah, this is good for Complexity because they're winning mid, they're not dying top, he's getting levels, and he's getting farm on his, like, this is a 5 support Leshrac now with just through pulling, he's level 4 at 4 minutes. That's astounding. It's very, very good.
Yeah.
I really wish that Wisp would stack more. He did get 2 stacks the last minute, so that's good. So things are going pretty well for Complexity.
See double damage picked up by Faceless Ford in the meantime, but yeah, so you refer to him as a 5 here, and he hits level 5, in fact, but if you're looking to pick up some items and farm, I mean, Leshrac feels like a support that can actually farm pretty well, as we see here.
He's level 5 at 4 minutes. This is really, really fast. This is like a core timing, honestly, of levels to minute ratio.
Yeah. So maybe this is the idea, right, where they figure they're going to have a support that just gets to be able to jungle, essentially, instead of actually, you know, worrying about that support role necessarily as far as babysitting and whatnot, so.
Yeah. Well, and the reason why this works out is because Leshrac can kind of just pull and do his own thing and farm, because Ursa can just solo the Void. There's no way Void can straight up, you know, free farm in this lane without taking a lot of damage. I mean, 1-2 auto attacks, and he's gotta use a time walk away.
Yeah.
So it's just the lane setups happen to be favorable for Complexity right now.
Yeah, so not the most aggressive game here out of 5.5 minutes. Obviously still just sitting on that first blood happening in the middle lane here in favor of Cancel. As Timbersaw, though, levels are starting to add up, so he's got that Timber chain, of course, for escape. Middle lane, oh, we definitely see a gank coming. Here comes the smoke. Way too sitting on the uphill. Z-Freak's walking right into a trap. Nothing he could do there. And Oracle with the kill, so good job with the smoke over, and, well, that's a kill.
Yep, tons of damage onto a poor little Wisp with no stats.
Level 2 Wisp still.
Is he level 3? Wow.
Yeah.
He's, so okay. He has turned into the 5.
Yeah, he's been walking up and down as you're talking about, you know, not really getting a whole lot of experience in places, and Dyer's middle it's kind of showing there.
Well, and that's not good in the sense that, you know, being able to use Relocate with the Nyx is very, very strong, as we saw in the last series yesterday.
Yeah.
So that's going to come online much, much later, probably somewhere around like the 12-minute mark.
Oh, he's going to babysit Cancel. They want it. I don't know what the plan is here. Maybe go for the jungle a little bit, it looks like, but yeah, babysitting a lot of pinks coming out, and here comes the mark. So, yeah, going to take out these stacks right here you're talking about. Make sure you get those jungle stacks going on.
So yeah, I think Melon should give the Wisp care the experience. I think he really needs it. So he's going to walk towards mid. Yeah,
yeah.
This is good. He needs this experience very badly.
It does seem like Melon's, I believe I saw him purchase some that ward there and even place it. So he's still investing into those, you know, that 5 roll support, it seems like. A little bit of farm that he's got as a result of the jungle.
Mm-hmm.
He takes over the mid now. He does get the Pulse Nova at level 6. Yeah, I'm actually, is that normally a thing, especially as a support, to get that ultimate at level 6?
Yeah, you always want to get it level 6 Leshrac, yeah. Like, no questions asked. Just because the amount of damage that it does for the amount of mana it requires is just the ratio is so favorable for you, so.
Yeah.
In fact, most of the time, I mean, I would say, like, almost all the time, you're going to leave it. Oh, a stun actually does land, an open stun onto Snaking. Oh, look at that damage coming out from the 5 position / 4 position Leshrac, and a very easy kill onto the Timber Sun. Nicely done.
I mean, Orko ported in immediately and just did not have a chance to even react to the target by the time he got there. Yeah, that was a lot of impressive bursts, definitely.
And that's that level one Pulse Nova you're just asking about. It does so much damage, and it costs almost nothing in terms of mana. And what I was going to add on to that was, action on bottom. Hopefully taking a little bit of damage, but we'll be okay. That skin on Ursus,
middle, by the way,
almost looks like he's ulting.
Tinker's
constantly
in trouble. He gets stunned in. Oracle follows up. They didn't have any damage. I don't know what the plan was there. Meanwhile, actually, Faceless does go down. So I was watching mid on the gank attempt, but Faceless gets picked off. So I believe you were still watching that. They just chased him down.
Yeah, so Ursa put a lot of damage onto him, forced out the time walk, but because Ursa went for this phase boots plus wind lace plus the tether movement speed added onto that, he was actually just able to walk up and catch up to the Void, even after he time walked. So, and Void wasn't 6, nothing he could do. He's actually so close to level 6, he just dinged it right now.
Oh, he has a crush here.
He would have liked to be level 6 about 15 seconds ago.
That would have been nice, yeah. Still be alive. Would have hit that even sooner, in fact. Smoke of the Sea just purchased by Melons right here, so we'll see if any smoke does come out. Klinks, meanwhile, this is kind of that core presence that he can be.
There's a sentry down, though.
Oh, is there? Yeah, there is, actually. He's not even invis right now. He's just kind of walking up. He walks up to last shot. There's those shots you're talking about. Split Earth is going to stun him, though, but it's not going to be nearly enough. He gets taken out. However, the Dust was used, and now Ziz in trouble. Cancel and Moo doing play. Oh, never mind. I guess Dust wasn't used. I thought I saw it.
Middle tower is under attack.
All right, he's going to be good, actually. I know Leshrac had Dust on him, so I guess he died before he used it.
Yeah, maybe they get the kill because they slow him down just a bit, but it'd be hard. I mean, Tinker doesn't really have good ways to catch up to heroes that are quicker than him, so unless he gets a blink. But that was totally fine for Complexity. I mean, Zizzy wasted his time. He didn't get the kill. The neutrals got it. Mid lane, we see a stun. Dire Courier goes down. Snaking, I think he's going to be fine, but Courier does go down.
That's annoying. Yeah, that was a Vendetta use there by Moo, so Courier pick. Always can be satisfied with that in the end. Tinker does purchase his bots, meanwhile. He's looking strong in the early game. It feels like four cancel here. So, yeah, I gotta say, as there's the Blink Dagger on Ursa already picked up. But I gotta say, this Leshrac pick has actually proved to be pretty viable so far for Complexity.
I wouldn't even say it was the pick. I'd say it's more of just his movement in the early game. He could have been any hero in kind of the same thing would have happened as long as he was pulling and using the same movements. Except for, of course, the kill in mid. That was all Leshrac just happened to hit his stun and tons of damage with the ult. But
yeah,
good movement here for Complexity. Their cores are ridiculously farmed right now. Very good timing for them. Blink, phase boots up onto Ursa, bots onto the Tinker. Things are looking really, really good for them. Open stun up onto way to top.
They just chase
it down. Dodges the stun as well. Very, very nice kill there from Complexity.
Yeah, that was just good coordination. Yeah, landing that split earth, as you mentioned, when opening with it, not the easiest sometimes, but catching from the fog there. And secure that kill. Bottom lane, Invis versus Invis. You see Klinks nearby with his Invis as well, but Vendetta open on to flee. Getting a time walk away.
They might have been able to get that kill if Moo landed that stun.
Oh, that's awkward. Oh, Ziz just opened right in front of Moo. He's going to be fine, though.
Zizzy's taking a lot of time trying to find these ganks, but he's just not connecting. So his farm is going to start to decrease slowly. He's opening up the map at least for way two to maybe get some farm, but he's quite far away from a blink, so I think that slowly in the next 5 to 6 minutes, Complexity's just going to really out-farm Doo-Wop. Oh, there's smoke! They smoke right next to an Invis, and they miss the dust! Feels bad, man. His snaking totally foils their plans right there.
He just outplayed them hard there, man. No, that was, that's just unfortunate for Complexity. Now he's just still walking around here towards the middle, even. Gonna flank on the Nyx right here, and never mind. No one's really coming in, so just continue to be that movable ward. Look at the vision, by the way, with that set coming out by the Dire here. I mean, that's some very aggressive wards earlier on in this game, all the way in the Radiant Jungle.
Unfortunately, they already took the huge decks, so they're a little bit late on that, but still, I guess, gives good vision. I don't think Tinker's going to be farming there anymore. He's going to be pushing out lanes and farming the lanes, rather.
Yeah.
This Ursa skin, whenever he uses overpower, it looks like he ults to me. I don't know, maybe I'm just crazy.
He does glow quite a bit, yeah.
Yeah, it looks a lot like his ult to me, but
maybe that's why he uses it.
Maybe.
Game advantage.
He throws up like, hey, he ulted, go on him.
Yeah.
Nope, he didn't.
Well, there's a Ursa shock there, but going to be fine.
Ooh, wow, Oracle's only level 4. I mean, he's about to hit 5, but talking about low-leveled supports, that is... I mean, I guess Wisp just hit 6, so he's not too far down from him. Open stun again onto the Void. He does get the time lock up, so he's going to be okay.
There's TP's down there. They want to make a play, actually, but Ursa's going to blink dagger away. We'll be fine. Meanwhile, top lane, Klinx goes down. That's a huge pick for Complexity, of course. The support's coming down here. So, and actually, Z-Freak, though, gets... Well, relocated back in, and he gets picked up at the result, but we're not done just yet. Fleet dives in, Chronosphere. He didn't catch Jake initially, but then he walks right into it. The locker there for Ursa. Going to try to chase him now. Leshrac, maybe can he land a stun of Split Earth? No, he misses it, actually. And there's a stun from Sand King now. Moo going to take it. Pops the armor of his, though, and down goes Sand... who was that? Yeah, Sand King gets picked off, actually, by Cancel, so...
There's just some big miscommunication errors on Doo-Wop. Some heroes are going in, some heroes are going out. They're not all on the same page, and it's really, really obvious, and Complexity's taking advantage of that.
Yeah. 6-2 lead now. Obviously, again, picking up Klinx. Huge to even startle that off. And see Klinx now back to the top lane. I mean, well, what should we be seeing from Klinx? I mean, we talked about how he was roaming earlier. He did get the pick, or was even killed by the neutrals, as mentioned. But, I mean, Klinx, should he be active as he's kind of trying to be, or would you rather see him just static, you know, farm the jungle?
It's hard to be static against the Nyx Wisp combo. That's what killed him last time. So I think you need to honestly keep moving around. I don't think you can, unless you're going to have, like, an Oracle sitting behind you or a Sand King baiting you, unless you have heroes bait you, I don't think you can sit in the lane and farm.
Yeah. Spray here. He is level 6, as we've seen, of course, so has that relocate, and going to partner up with Just Oh, they're going top lane, actually. Did they find... Okay, they found Klinx, but it got killed by the neutrals. So that was the plan, but unfortunately comes up short on a Klinx. So a little bit of revenge there in a way for Klinx. You know, he's like, all right, you had neutrals earlier, now it's my turn. But still, I mean, him being dead is obviously a benefit for Complexity. And they will take that every day of the week. So now going to pressure the top tower, it seems like, and... Probably gonna be a tower kill, actually, by Complexity. I don't know if Doo-Wop is gonna be looking to defend this here. Doesn't seem like it. So, there we go. There's a dead tower. Meanwhile, bottom lane. See, pushing back the creep wave. You got Sand King nearby, just dealing with some illusions here. Blink dagger on Sand King. Yeah, he's still way off. He only has 500 gold currently. It's not gonna be happening soon here. Well, looks like Trouf might have dropped. He does have that storm going on over there, so he hiccuped earlier as well, so obviously we'll get him to reconnect here shortly. And hopefully be good to go there. So anyway, 6-2 lead for Complexity, about 15 and a half minutes into this game right now. We got Nyx Assassin, that Vendetta. He's roaming around looking for an opening, but not going to find any just yet. But we talked about that Klinx, and you know, even though he got killed by the neutrals last time, he was found again in that jungle. So it really seems like a difficult game for Klinx. He is going to go aggressive now. As he heads towards the bottom here. And looking to find a kill. JK actually just picking up that basher of his, but gonna fall back to the tower before they're able to open on him, actually. Where he'll be fine. Middle lane, we do have action, and they do pick off Timbersaw. He got relocated to the middle lane, so they're trying to gank him bottom, and they relocate middle instead to take out Timbersaw. So looks at his movement, gotta say, is pretty impressive, especially compared to yesterday. Match, but looks like let me give him a call again. I think he might be back here. Nope, might still be having an issue. You there?
I'm there.
Okay.
I'm here.
There and here. Welcome back.
Yep, there's quite a storm here. It just flickers on and off though, so it's not like it's leaving for an extended period of time.
Yeah, that's good at least.
Yeah.
But yeah, we saw right there again, as I was mentioning before you. Right after you cut out, really. They were trying to gank Ursa at the bottom lane, and then all of a sudden they relocate mid and take out Timbersaw with the rest of the team. And so it's just the movement is actually pretty impressive from Complexity of this game, especially in comparison to yesterday, the match against
NP. And as you mentioned, taking the page out of NP's book with the... Oh, I hear something going. Oh, it's just... I thought Klinx was ganking someone, but he's just hitting these dragons. Action on the way to...
Yeah,
the magic resistance, or I should say immunity, coming out from Jason's pretty helpful against the Leshrac.
Gonna be fine for the time being as a result. Mu, though, he's running, and he wants to make a play right here. He's gonna hit the Impale. Mana Burn on top of that. There's the... Nope, not gonna hit the stun, actually. We'll be fine, so... Just continuing the harassment here, as now here comes the March. What are we looking at with Tinker as far as his progression? Yeah, he has the Blink Dagger. Looks like he's working on that Aether Lens here, so... He's really got his core taken care of, it's safe to say. on the Tinker. Now, yesterday, speaking of the Knicks, I mean, you were really mentioning how the axe is just so good on that hero.
Yeah.
Do you think Moose should be getting it here soon, or?
Oh, yeah. I mean, every Knicks should buy it. It's just I see a big variance in the order in which Knicks players buy their items. Some will just go straight up man. Oh, speaking of Moo, he runs around, but he should be a fine. Some Knicks will go straight into the Ags right after Mana Boots, like we saw yesterday. This game, it looks like Moo wants to go for the Midas, so he's going Mana Boots Midas. Maybe Mana Boots Midas Blink. Maybe Mana Boots Midas Ags.
Yeah.
But no matter what, they will always go for the Ags. It's just too good of an item to pass up.
Oh, Envious picked up by Melons up here again, level 9, so he definitely has some damage potential with his build here. The Diabolic Edict, level 3 currently, and oh, might run into Oracle, actually. He also has a Nyx nearby. There's the Impel. Here's what is going to hit, and Oracle, yep, will be enough for the kill. However, what it costs here, they're going to look for the turn. As the Quintus Spear comes out, there's a stun in the Epicenter coming out from Sand King, and it's a 2-for-1 exchange, so the bait is real, we'll call it that, from Oracle. And
yep,
they get two kills.
Definitely a good rebuttal kill, but that TP from Sneaky was kind of interesting because they were definitely going to kill them without. And I think they need to spend time spreading out the map and getting farm. They're massively losing the farm war. Ursa will kind of tap out somewhat soon. I mean, he's very, very strong. He can, of course, can get stronger, but Tinker is just going to spread the map so much. And you need to spend time farming too, so. Yeah, it's great that they got these kills, but if they're spending every single hero to do source, especially if it's not on a major core like Ursa or Tinker, they're just going to fall so far behind.
Yeah. Soul Booster just purchased by Timbersaw, so that Bloodstone is in the works here, but 19 and a half minutes into the game, so trying to make that happen. But Moon, meanwhile, again, you just always see him in the front lines up here with that Vendetta, as you would expect, looking for yet another opportunity. The Tether...
He missed the Carapace.
Did he miss it? Okay.
Yeah, he tried to get it on the way back for the Chakram, but wasn't able to get it. So Bash on to Jason. Mercer gets some lucky RNG.
Oh, jeez, that was brutal right there. Meanwhile, they relocate out, actually, and now Moo and Melons are left to their own to fight this off. Oh, no, they're close enough, actually, so not necessarily the biggest deal. They just go a little bit backwards. They do pick off Timbersaw in the end, positioning pretty on point here for Complexity. They're going to go further. Way too. The stun is not enough. Tinker will get him killed with some rockets coming in. Well played by Complexity again. A 3-for-nothing fight recap there in their favor. And now have their biggest lead as a result. So, yeah, that Bash, hey, sometimes the gods are on your side.
Yeah, I mean, when you attack so quickly, you're bound to get it in at least, you know, 4 or 5 attacks. And his overpower gives him 6 attacks, so he's bound to get it in that duration. I'm really surprised that in these skirmishes, especially when they relocated out for a split second, that they're not aiming the Leshrac. It's a hero that's the easiest to kill on their team by far, and for the ratio of how much health he has for how much damage he does, he's bigger than anyone else on his team, so I'm really surprised that they're not focusing him, especially when he's in the middle lines here. They went onto the Nyx there. I think Way2 tried to get a double stun, but just, I mean, they weren't very close, so he ended up only getting the Nyx, and so not only is the communication just suspect here from Doo-Wop, but their prioritization of which heroes I want to go to doesn't seem very sound.
Yeah. Oh, you see Tinker at the top lane again, just pushing in the lane. Klinks was nearby, but quickly falls back, feeling some pressure. And again, his farm continues to be, I mean, not that great. I mean, you look at his inventory here, and it just feels somewhat weak. He does have an Oblivion Staff in the stash right there, but work to be done for, is it Zizzy or Ziz? I've been saying Ziz.
Oh, well, he has a Y at the end.
It does have a Y at the end, so I guess it is Zizzy. I thought it used to be Ziz,
come on.
Maybe. I mean,
it used to be Ziz. Sometimes. It used to be.
Maybe that's why I said, okay. Sworn it did. So a little bit of saving grace there.
Yeah, his farm is just... And the funny thing is he's the most farm on his team, but it's just negligible farm. He does have the Orchid now. He must have been hiding his other Oblivion Staff somewhere.
Yeah.
Maybe in a stash on the courier. Doesn't see Moo right now. There is a gem that was just picked up on Side of Complexity. Who has it now? I think it's the... I swear I saw it.
I don't see any, actually.
Oh, it was on the courier right now. It was being sent out to... Okay, so Z-Freak bought it, and now the Leshrac has it. Should go to the Nyx, and it does. So he's going to be able to find that Klinks very easily. Klinks picks up the Invis right in front of the face of Melons. Oh, dodges the dust again. I don't think they could do anything with that anyway, though.
Not going to hit, so going to use that last count of that. Is this a smoke here? Yes, it is. Doo-Wop smoke towards mid.
good time to fight, too, because just got the Bloodstone up on the Snaking, so he's going to have, bam, 13 charges just like that. This is a small way to come back. Yeah.
Pick off Melons here again. It is a support Leshrac, but still, any pick you'll definitely take at this point, so good for them. Zizzy, meanwhile, top lane. He's going to burn down that tower, and he'll do so successfully. Nice job right-click auto-turreting into it. And gets the kill. So I want to bring up actually the Medallion of Courage picked up by Leshrac. Is that an item that makes sense to you?
I don't know. I'm not sold by it. Moo's trying to find. Oh, he actually had a sentry down.
There's Relocate coming in. The Impale Relocate coming to this mansion. There's a Chronosphere though, and it hits the Nyx Assassin. JK also caught in the midst of it. Wait, just still alive. Finally gonna fall though. That cleave damage just is real though. The Chakram in the middle of it, not gonna matter. Faceless Void goes down with his teammate of the Sand King there, and the chase kind of continues over here. But looks like they are going to make their way out, that being Timbersaw specifically. Oh, now he's going for a kill on Z-Freak, it seems like. Timberchain forward, but here comes the Ursa now. It's Snake King regretting this decision. The bash off the bat, and he will fall. Mega kill streak for Ursa. Never a good sign to see as the opposition here.
Yeah, they're just not going on the right heroes. The Carapace was up. I think when he Chronosphered, you can't go in the Ursa because A, he's tanky, B, he had the Aegis, C, he had the Wisp healing him up and preventing damage. You have to go in the Wisp, you have to go in the supports. And I think Melon's was dead because he just died right before that exchange, but definitely could have maybe gone on the Wisp, but it was just awkward. He already committed the Chrono. He's like, I got two people in Chrono. I'm hitting these two people in this Chrono.
It's like, wait a second. I don't do a lot of damage, though.
Well,
so.
Snakeen did have the Chakram through, but it wasn't enough damage. It didn't do anything.
Feels a little too weak right now. And again, obviously, there was Klinks at the top lane there. He was dealing with his own issues, or more so just pushing in. Wasn't able to be in the fight, basically. And without him, he's definitely a big damage dealer for the team. The biggest of sorts, he'd figure in some ways. So. Not great with him not being there now. 15-5 lead as a result. His biggest net worth, I'm sure. Yeah, we take a look at the graph real quickly. Over 10,000 now, and upwards of 10,000 experience lead in favor of Complexity. So they got to be feeling really good right about now. Now it's not a game one just yet, but they are in total control here. So where does this? I mean, they have the Orchid now on Klink. So I mean, that's big, right? So is that the start of a comeback, or?
It's really not. The thing is I don't know if I think that. That big of a pickup here, unless you're killing the Wisp and maybe like orchiding someone else at the same time. I mean, he's just got to be really, really fluid with that motion. But if you're orchiding someone and it's not the Wisp, he's just going to heal that person or he's going to relocate them out.
Yeah.
I'm not the biggest fan of the Orchid Rush. Thought he was going to go for the Deso, but I was wrong. Orchid's generally good on Klinks when you get it very, very fast. I'm talking like 11 minutes or something.
Oh no, Sand King. I'm sorry, way too sexy. Maybe sexy, but you are dead sexy right now. Anyways, he goes down right there. You got Timbersaw just falling back. Oh, they found Klinks in the midst of that. I thought they were chasing over here on Timbersaw. Meanwhile, Klinks just caught in the middle of it. He also got picked off. That character's just so tiny. I guess he picked off Leshrac, but it's like, so that's what you're talking about. Like, that's the right target, but to suicide yourself to do so.
Yeah.
Not good value necessarily.
Nope. He was angry at his ex-captain. Wanted to get some, some revenge or something.
May have been
Lincoln,
that.
Instant bash. That's the second first hit bash. That was crazy.
Oh, jeez. Yeah, he's just bashing them left and right. And I think Doo-Wop is definitely feeling the pain here. I mean, this top lane is going to be pushed in very heavily again. Leshrac's actually up in 10 seconds anyways. So.
I also think there's a big question mark on the, tried to get the lucky first hit bash, but couldn't get it.
Never lucky.
Yeah, never lucky. Is that a crypt thing? Are you saying that because of crypt?
No, okay. I mean, maybe. Might be. Okay, there's, I want to say that's the first false promise we've seen this whole game. I meant to bring that up earlier that, he hasn't, because I'm pretty sure it's just because out of position or, he hasn't really been there in time or he just dies really quickly, so.
I don't know about this Manta. He rushed a Manta, and by rushed, I mean it wasn't really rushed at all. It's 27 minutes. I think there's I see a relocate onto Zizzy. They caught him.
Yeah, that
I
was.
I didn't know if it was necessary, but he is just dead.
That was the Nyx. Yeah, again, having that gem on Nyx is huge. He just sees him walking right next to them with the skeleton walk. He's like, hey, I see you, you don't see me. And just opens, and no chance for the Klinks there, so. I think it's just a matter of time before Complexity breaks through and, looks to take care of business here, but Klinks is what? What is that for Klinks here? Four. Okay, it's only four deaths. It even felt like more than that, but 1, 4, and 2. not the
but
sexiest.
But he's just not offering anything in fights, and he wasn't able to, you know, to his credit, he was looking for kills. He got kind of unlucky on the first one because there just happened to be a sentry down in the area that he was ganking, and Leshrac died to the newts. But even if he gets the Leshrac kill and he doesn't die to the newts, is it really worth it? I don't think so. I think you need to, like, they needed to pressure maybe the safe. I mean, they're just, their laning phase was a disaster, and then it just kind of snowballed from there. You had cores like Tinker with 9-minute bots. You had like 9-minute, 10-minute phase blink on the Ursa. It's just too hard to deal with.
look at Klinks right there. He buys actually a gem of his own, so now he at least is able to see the Nyx with a Vendetta nearby if that happens again. Also just good vision to have in general, of course, but they're going to move out as a team right here. They're not smoked or anything like that. They're just simply trying to get some vision across the map. Oh, Klinks, though. You see Nyx running in now. They got the gem, remember, so they can't see move for a split second right there. Some fight's going to happen. He will open out a flea immediately, but Nyx is in trouble. Here comes a whiff trying to save out the Chronosphere. Catches him, and he goes down. That is a big chrono. You got the BKB up on JK in the midst of it, but look at the dire side. Well, I mean, well, don't look at them because they're all dead. You got Timbersaw trying to get away. It you know, that seemed like it was actually working decent for them initially, and then it just didn't.
I mean, the Tinker is so far. I don't know if you saw the ags there, but the missile's going onto everybody, and, you know, it's a funny thing. Tinker's actually somewhat good against Void, because even if your teammates get chronoed, you can, if you have the ags, he casts a laser, he just disarms everybody, and then the chrono is just kind of nullified. It was just a matter of fact is that they just had way too much farm on their cores. The laning phase was a disaster for Doo-Wop.
Yeah.
And Complexity had really, really good movement early on.
Yeah, no, that was definitely an impressive Complexity performance, again, especially on the heels of yesterday's against Team NP. So I think that's going to, you know, at least maybe a sigh of relief for some Complexity fans. Like, okay, so maybe yesterday wasn't just what we should expect moving forward. But, again, still a lot of work to be done at the same time. Yeah, but Doo-Wop, I will say, they, as you were pointing out several times, I mean, mistakes were definitely to be had in several places of that game. Have some fine-tuning to do themselves here before we see game number two. But as far as draft, I mean, the Leshrac pick, you were mentioning, I guess it could have been a lot of support options. He was just playing the idea of it well. But do you think the Leshrac did work there in the end? I mean, did it make sense in the end?
Again, in terms of the laning phase, he could have been any hero. Like, he still could have. He wasn't really harassing the Void much, and he really, there's very few supports that can harass a Void much. What worked about it was that the Ursa could harass Void. So whether he wanted to go stack or roam or check the rune or do whatever, it didn't matter because it wasn't like, oh no, I'm leaving my weak, like, I don't know, I'm just going to use Gyrocopter here against the Void that Void can freeform. No, you can't. You can leave your Ursa to freeform against the Void, so it's fine. So in that sense, he could have been any hero, but to his credit, to Melon's credit, he hit a lot of open stuns, and so he actually made the hero work as a result of hitting those skill shots.
Yeah. All right, guys. Well, that's going to do it for game number one. Again, Complexity takes the game. We'll see what happens in game number two. Going to be coming up. Sit tight, guys. We'll be back. Game number two coming back here for the Summit 6 American Qualifiers. I'm Breaking CPK, joined by Trouf. We'll be right back, guys.